Hey there, it's Rachel Mullins, the host of Hashtag No Filter Fridays on Public House Media.
This is Bryce Burge, host of Your Soccer Passport here on Public House Media. After this episode, come join us on a trip around the soccer world as we discuss club and country every Tuesday. Stamp Your Soccer Passport by subscribing on Spotify, iTunes, or wherever you get your Public House Media podcasts. And thanks again for checking out the following broadcast on Public House Media.
Don't worry about anything. Instead, pray about Welcome to Choose to Rise, where today we're going to be talking about six ways to reduce your anxiety. And if you want to connect with me more, if you want to be a part of what we're doing here at Choose to Rise, you can head over to choosetoriseup.com. You can also find us on Facebook and be a part of what we're doing there as well. So today I want to share with you a little bit about what it is that you can do to reduce some anxiety, things that you can do to really calm yourself down. And we all have some level of anxiety, even if you don't like formally suffer from anxiety. We all have those like nervous, jittery feelings that are kind of in the pit of your belly. So maybe it's the night before you do a public speaking event. Maybe it's maybe you're nervous about going to a party. Maybe you're nervous about something you have to do at school. Something that just kind of gets your palms sweaty and your heart racing. That's a form of some sort of anxiety. So today, I want to share with you six little things that I've done in my world to help me overcome some of these things, and six little things that you can do to kind of reduce some of that anxiety. Okay, so let's get rolling here. Six ways that you can reduce your anxiety. My quote at the very beginning was, don't worry about anything, instead pray about everything. And you know, that verse comes from Philippians 4:6, but it's so true. Like, God wants us to come to him with all of our struggles, with all of our strife, and you know, not worry about things, because when we worry about things that we can't control, it oftentimes snowballs into other feelings and emotions, and it just puts our energy in the wrong place. But if you can focus on the positive things and understand that you don't necessarily have control over everything, because you know that it's true, you don't have control over things. And when you start to get that kind of out of control feeling, that's where the anxiety and the panic attacks and like those kinds of things start to settle in. And so, you know, the fear of having that anxiety attack or the fear of having that, you know, out of control feeling is what usually drives those kinds of things to happen. So I'm going to give you six things today that you can use to kind of calm yourself down, to refocus your energy is really what it's about, and use these kind of tactics and tricks in your day to feel good about where you're at in life. So the first one is kind of yoga and meditation. You know, research indicates that yoga and meditation can significantly lower anxiety and lower stress levels. In the previous episode, we talked about reducing stress, and you know, the stress on your body, the stress that you create in your mind, the stress that you have in your life is oftentimes because we hold on to things. And so if you can release that stuff with some meditation, letting your mind flow, and you know, releasing some of that stress in your body by doing some yoga and some stretching and those kinds of things, just being at peace, having those controlled physical movements, being aware of your body, regulating your breathing and mental relaxation really helps yourself kind of get into a place where you can let go of some of that anxiety, let go of some of that tension, let go of the things that are holding you back. Another tip and trick is to get 8 to 9 hours of quality sleep. Now, sleep pattern plays a huge role in this, in all kinds of things in your life. The way your body is able to repair itself, the way it has mental strength to keep doing things, it gives yourself endurance. But the less sleep you get at night, the more likely you're to feel anxious about the next day. It can be a kind of a bit of a vicious cycle. Anxiety can contribute to insomnia or lack of quality of sleep, and lack of quality of sleep can exacerbate anxiety. So developing good sleep habits and making quality sleep a priority can help break that cycle. researchers indicate all kinds of things about good sleep habits that will help you dispel lots of fears, that will help you, you know, really have the good endurance and sleep habits that are going to help you be your best the next day. And so you can have mental clarity, you can have all that stuff. Did you know that I read this in a book somewhere once, that sleeping at night is when your brain is able to get rid of the negative things in your head. Like all of the things that build up throughout the day. So kind of like, think of it as like a street where like trash is kind of like thrown out on a daily basis. I don't know about you, but like, does that happen where you live? Not so much here in Iowa. We're a pretty clean state. But think about it as like, you have just had a big parade and there's like, or you've been at a gym and like there's been a basketball game and all the people leave and there's all the stuff laying around, like their popcorn bags and all that kind of stuff. Well, that's kind of like how your brain is like at night. So like you get done with all the thoughts running around in your head, all the synapses firing and everything. And then at night when your body relaxes and you start to sleep, that's when your brain can like flush out all the crap that's been left behind, and it can start to repair and it starts to reconnect the things that needs to, and really clean up the environment kind of thing. So when you can sleep at night and really get that good rest, that's when you can be clear in the morning. You can be more productive the next day because you've been able to kind of rejuvenate yourself. The third thing is a nutrient-dense diet. Most of us don't associate diet with anxiety, but nutrition plays a huge role. I have lots of private clients that have worked themselves off of anxiety medications because they have improved their nutrition. I'm not saying you should stop your medication. What I'm saying is you should think about how you can improve your whole foods like B vitamins and zinc and magnesium and omega-3s, and really start thinking about what it is that you're putting into your body if they're trying to get the things out of your body. So if you're dealing with chronic prolonged stress, or if you're finding, you know, inflammation in your body, if you're kind of trying to like battle those stress types of things, start eating stress-busting foods. Start thinking about the things that your body needs in order to maintain that mood. Try to reduce the stress in your body. Try to get rid of the free radicals in your system, and really just fuel it with good stuff. And you'll be able to really, you know, when your body's fueled well, it can do good things. So think about that. The next thing you do is limit refined carbs. Yeah. Do you like pie? Do you like candies? Do you like the things that are like all the good, all the carbs in the world? I'm not saying cut out carbs. What I'm saying is cut out the refined carbs, the sweet tooth things. You know, I love peanut butter. I love Nutella. I love cookies. I love cake. I love ice cream, right? But those are the kinds of things should be controlled. Like, think about, you know, they may look and taste delicious, but if they are, there's a strong correlation between reduced sugar diet and lowered anxiety. If you're, again, it kind of goes back to that before, like if you are filling your body with things that it doesn't need, if you're filling your body with the junk that it's not going to serve it well, it's going to, the things that go into your body are the things that are going to come out of your body. So just remember it that way. How you treat your body is how it's going to respond to you in the future. So you don't have to say no to sweets completely. You don't have to say no to sugary carbs completely. But if you significantly lower those things in your body, you're going to, and reduce the heavily processed foods that are, you know, high in refined carbs and high in sugar and just high in things that are man-made and not God-made, you'll be able to, your God-made body will be able to function better because you're doing that. Now, another tip and trick is to get early morning sunshine. I know not everyone is an early morning person. I myself have not been created as an early morning person. However, getting up in the morning early and getting in at least half hour a day of outside sunlight can really help improve your mood, can really help with positivity in your day and all kinds of stuff. So I know it can be tough, especially in the winter, like it is today here where I live, but you know, get bundled up, get outside, get some sunshine on your skin and really get that dose of sunlight every single day, whether it's right away in the morning or in midday. But natural sunlight triggers your brain's release of serotonin, which has the calming effect on you. So I love to get outside. We have a puppy now, and I think she was really kind of put in my life for a reason, that I have to get outside every day. I have to take her for a walk, and it's been the best thing. And when I look at her as an opportunity to look at the opportunity to go on a walk with her as a good thing, instead of like, oh, I have to take the dog for a walk. Like the way you tell yourself, the way you talk to yourself, it all matters. The next kind of tip or trick I have for you is daily journaling, or getting into a habit of a devotion. So I use I do this right away in the morning. Journaling is a very effective way to reduce anxiety, getting your thoughts out on paper. It's a great way to, it's an old fashioned way maybe, but it's, you know, putting hand to paper and maybe not necessarily typing it, but really getting the thoughts out from your brain through your arm and out onto the paper is what's really the calming effect on the brain. So the same thing kind of comes into like adult coloring or just being creative, like we talked about in a previous episode. It doesn't matter what you write. It doesn't matter if you pour out your thoughts and feelings. It doesn't matter if you're doing gratitude. As long as you're reinforcing your brain to think positively, even when you're writing about things that are causing you anxiety or things that are stressing you out, you're kind of releasing those things out into the world and they're not inside of you anymore. So I write every single day. I have a devotion here that's called Bound Blessings that I've been reading lately, and I absolutely love it. If you want to get this devotion, you can totally go to boundblessings.com/books and order your own. I think it's like $10, and you can, it's really good. It's short and sweet, and it really just gets you thinking about things. And then I journal about the entry that day. So I will journal about the devotion that I just read. Today was about discovering differences and how differences in our life and really learning to accept it with love. So I journaled about that. And then I wrote my own kind of prayers to God and the things that I've been thinking about. So those are great ways that you can get your thoughts on paper, that you can really reduce some anxiety and talk to God about the things that are causing you stress. He already knows these things, but wants you to come to him. Pray about everything, worry about nothing, right? And so go to him and he will help you release those anxieties. He will help you release all that tension in your life and focus you in on the good things that he's created you for. The next one is called create a tidy environment. Declutter your living space as much as possible. I know there's a huge fad going on right now. There's a Netflix series all about tidying up everything, and I've not yet watched it. However, lots of my friends have been doing so, and I agree with them. You don't have to head to a complete minimalist lifestyle, but there is something about an uncluttered environment that helps just your brain function better. So if you're not into a whole house cleaning spree, you'll benefit from cleaning things up a little bit. One habit that I tend to do when I go drop my kids off in the morning, I come home, I kind of just pick up the house a little bit. So, you know, things that are laying here or there, I take stuff to their room. I clean up the kitchen. I make sure things are just kind of tidy. And it doesn't take very long, maybe 5 minutes, but I just feel good about the space that I'm working in or the space that when my family does come home, they have a clean environment to come home to. Again, I'm not like doing a major deep clean. I'm just picking things up and I'm uncluttering my environment. And it just kind of releases some of that anxiety of like, whoa, what if someone were to come over, right? So it just, you kind of get rid of those things. And the last one I have for you is 30 minutes of daily exercise. Pick your exercise of choice and just do it. Even if it's just going for a brisk walk when you're getting your sunshine outside, even if it's, a run, maybe it's pushing play on a workout like I do, maybe it's weights, maybe it's dance, maybe it's something that you're just getting active. Maybe it's a bike. You get to decide what it's going to be, but I know from personal experience that that exercise is what makes me feel good. It gives me energy. It's a stress reducer for me. It is something that really helps me be my best. Not only am I growing my endurance, my physical endurance, and strengthening my lungs and strengthening my heart, but I also, it's a mental battle a lot of days, and I am able to strengthen my mind by the soundtrack that goes through my head. So by focusing on the positive things and focusing on the good things and overcoming the struggle that sometimes exercise is, you can grow in that strength and you can grow in the positive things and reduce a lot of the anxiety that you have in your life. So, a lot of people that I told you earlier that I work with on a regular basis are focusing in on exercise and diet and surrounding yourself with positive people, filling your head with good stuff, filling your body with good stuff and moving your body more helps so very much when you're doing things in life. So I hope and pray that, if you have been working on some of these things, if you have been, if you need to focus on other things in life that are going to help you and support you, that you can do those things. And finally, you can use these things to reduce the anxiety and the stress of your life. But if you really come down to it where you need to seek professional help, do it. There is no shame in that. There is no, there is a stigma out there, but you shouldn't worry about it, because seeking professional help to get the help that you need to overcome the things that you have going on in your life, whether it's to talk to someone and just release those things with a professional that can help you with those things, if it's, you know, if it has to be medication for a while, if it has to be things that are going to help you overcome the hurdles that are in your life, go do those things. You do not need to suffer alone. You do not need to suffer in your stress and anxiety and all those kinds of things. Seek professional help from a physician or a mental health provider if absolutely necessary. And if it's a low case thing, if it's a, it's just small stresses in life, use some of these activities, that these tips and things that I've shared with you today, and hopefully you can reduce some of those along with the other things that you've been doing in your life. So if you like today's show, I would love for you to find past episodes. You can go to Choose to Rise Up on Apple Podcasts, on Podbean, or out here on our website, and you can leave a rating and review there, because it helps other people find it and really learn to love Choose to Rise as well. I'd love to connect with my listeners. So if you leave a rating review, I'll try to share it here on the podcast. And I really thank you and appreciate you so very much for tuning in today. And if you have, if you want to get connected, I would love to do so. So thanks so much for joining me today. And I hope to see you again here very soon.